there is a beagle that was found nearby the shelter in the same city. That beagle has a slipped disc in the beagle's spine, and the surgery to fix it is very expensive. It's so expensive that I am going to talk to the vet tomorrow and verify, and as long as I get confirmation that that dog is in need and the money is going to go directly to the dog, I will donate the remaining money from what we raised. We spent about 300 something so far on their food for them, which was a great decision, so the dogs could eat. And now, unfortunately, the shelter's closing. Things aren't very good, but we knew that. But we gave them so much exposure that I know, guys, I know in my heart they were planning on killing those guys, those dogs. And we saved a mass euthanization. And then because of what we did, they got flooded with support, flooded with rescues, flooded with attention, flooded with exposure. And those dogs got picked up mostly by rescues. I remember there was about 200 dogs there, and then I heard that there was only 30. Right, so we saved hundreds of lives due to exposure. Now that is activating sharing mode. So thank you guys for being a part of that. That was amazing. But we're not done yet. We did start that You Caring so we could raise money for them to help them. And people, out of the goodness of their hearts, donated for Pets Without Parents to alleviate the crisis, to alleviate the crisis of those dogs in Sevierville, Tennessee. So, with good judgment, I was brought to attention of a beagle who has a slip disc. We are going to be donating the money there to help them alleviate the problems that that dog is going through. And I'm sure everyone's going to be really pleased with where the money went for that cause. It's going to be beautiful, guys. I'm a very busy guy, and sometimes it takes me a little while to get around to things, but I'm always working on them. So I heard some rumors and slander, nothing new. Of some people saying some stuff about what we're doing with that money that we raised for Pets Without Parents. And now exactly what I'm finding here is this is exactly where this money should be going. So it's great, guys. I'm so grateful. I'm going to post about it. I just have to confirm that that dog is there so it's not a scam. I always go through an approval process in my head which dogs we want to help and which dogs we want to care for. Because if we get known for donating for things and they're scams, no one's going to want to believe us anymore, which is why I didn't want to donate that money to that shelter, because I don't trust the shelter. So we donated directly for things like food, and now we're going to donate directly for this dog that very well would have ended up at that shelter. Okay, so that dog was a stray. That dog was found near the shelter. That dog would have went into the shelter system, and instead a very nice person is adopting the dog and needs help with the recovery and the bills. So that's exactly what we're going to do, and I love it. So thank you guys for believing in us and supporting us, because you guys are really spot on. Urgent Dogs of LA is growing more than you guys can even imagine. I'm getting really, 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 really good phone calls with my investors, my donors, my family, my friends. I mean, you guys are doing so well by spreading the word about us. And even the hate, even the slander, even the lies, it's bringing people over to our page. It's bringing people over to see dogs. It's bringing people involved in the discussions of, hey, this is dog rescue. I knew what was going on in dog rescue. Here's this guy.